Today in this video, I would like to share interview experience of Indian Space Research Organization of Akash Aditya. So he actually shared his experience with the Medici faculty Acharya Bansal. So he shared all the interview questions and how he answered them. So actually, I would like to clear that it is not my interview experience. It is the interview experience of one of my friends. So let's get started this video and we will know what are the questions that interviewer asked and how he answered them. Okay, so it consists of 9 to 10 members in the panel. One is HR ma'am, other is chairperson, and 8 persons are from technical background. So first question, the chairperson asked that tell me about yourself. Akash Aditya explained his university, that is MIT Muzaffarpur. He also had his CGPA, that is 8.34, and he told about his BTech project, that is pumpless evaporative air cooler. And everybody shocked about hearing that MIT, because MIT is a very deemed university. So member asked, the one person asked that it is a deemed university or state university. Then he replied, sir, no sir, it is a state university of Patna. Okay, so a person in South Indian language asked him that about his favorite subjects. So he told his favorite subject thermodynamics and heat transfer, strength of material and machine design. Okay, now onwards his technical interview proceeded further. So first technical question he faced that tell me about basic thermodynamic process. So he told, sir, isothermal, isentropic, isobaric and polytropic. He also added that almost all the reversible process can be explained in terms of polytropic process by changing polytropic index. So one person asked, is it almost or all the reversible process? So he modified us, no sir, not almost, all the reversible process can be transferred in terms of polytropic process. So the other question, member number three asked him that, sir, what is throttling process? What is throttling process? Then he told them that, sir, when a fluid is passed through a narrow tube or narrow hole or partially open valve, process is termed as throttling process. Then another person asked that go on the whiteboard and put the marker and draw the and prove that in the throttling process enthalpy is constant. So he uses steady flow energy equation with the help of SFEE. He proved that H1 is equal to S2. Basically in the SFEE equation we know half mv square plus rho gh plus H1 plus Q1 is equal to other part S2 plus W plus half mv square and rho gh. And he assumed that sir, there is no loss of heat and also the kinetic energy and potential energy remain same. So by using this this assumption he proved that H1 is equal to S2. And the next question the interviewer asked that what is the difference between diesel and petrol engine. So diesel petrol and dual cycle. So he explains that there is only one difference, that how we are adding the heat. This is the only difference. In the diesel cycle we add the heat at constant pressure, and in the auto cycle we add the heat at the constant volume, and in the dual cycle we add the heat at the constant volume, and it is a mixture of auto and diesel, constant volume and constant pressure. Okay, so and another person asked that draw the diesel cycle and petrol cycle and also explain all the process in the diesel and petrol cycle. So he draw diesel and petrol cycle and he explained all the processes. We know that there are 4 processes: suction, compression, power stroke and expansion and the exhaust. So there are the 4 process. And the next question is actually very tricky question, that interviewer asked that there are 2 rods, one is heated and other is not heated, so what will happen? So then Akash replied that sir, I am assuming that both rods are rigidly fixed. As they are rigidly fixed, there will be thermal stress developed in both the rods. Then another person asked that what will be the nature of the stress. So then he explained that the hotter rod will try to expand and the colder one will try to contract. When the hotter will try to expand, the colder rod will apply a compressive force. So the stress will develop in the hotter rod will be compression, and at the same time the tensile stress will be developed in the colder parts. So this is the part 1 of this video. I will upload part 2 of this video in the next video. So let's get skip this video and thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please like, subscribe, and if you have any doubt, please comments below. Thank you so much.